Hi, I'm Todd Anderson.
And I'm Gerry Thompson.
And you're watching the Versus series on StarCityGames.com. All right, we're here today playing some Oath of the Gatewatch Standard right before, what's Columbus?
Yes.
Yeah. Gerry Thompson, ladies and gentlemen.
What up?
How's it feel to be back?
It's interesting. Things have not really changed around here, which is, it's good, it's comforting, it's not a bad thing. It's good to be back.
Yeah, so you're saying I never change, I just never get better, never get worse.
No, I didn't say that you never got better.
Roanoke's basically purgatory. So.
No, absolutely not. Plus, we have like all the new transplants, which is awesome.
Yeah, so today we're going to be playing a little bit Oath of the Gatewatch Standard. Now, for you guys, you've already gotten a whole week's worth of new decks out of Atlanta. For us, we're filming this on Friday, right after the sets come out. So we're still playing with some brews.
Yeah, it's entirely possible that my deck is just not playable. I started with a Grixis Eldrazi list that was built by Brian DeMars, had Sire of Stagnation, which I thought was really sweet.
Sounds
and
cool.
Herald of Kozilek. And then the more I just kind of like tinkered with the deck and stuff, I was like, nah, I kind of just want to cut the black cards. I want to play like the Conduit of Ruins main deck. And yeah, eventually just got rid of the Sires, which, I don't know. I kind of wanted to play with that card, but.
Yeah, so Jerry's deck's a little off the wall. I'm excited to see just how good it is. I watched him goldfish a few games, and it looked real nice.
It looked great. It looked better than I thought it was, so hopefully, you know, that translates into the actual games, too, but
yeah.
We'll see.
So I'm going to be playing Mardu Green, which is a deck that gained a little bit of popularity in the last few months of the Battle for Zendikar Standard. You know, it's basically just a Mardu deck that splashes a little bit for, like, Den Protector and Siege Rhino.
Yep.
Because why not splash for Siege Rhino?
Yeah, I mean, the mana's kind of free because once you're Mardu, you have Wooded Foothills and Windswept Heath, and you kind of, like, need your Foothills to get a White Source, and then you have a Canopy Vista. You need, you need your Heath to get a red mana, so you have a Cinder Glade, and then you just have all these free green mana symbols lying around. So it's like, yeah, this is the color that you can just kind of add for free.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of the way it is for most of the cons-based three-color combinations. You know, that's why Jeskai Black has such an easy time splashing another color.
Right.
So yeah, I'm going to be playing Mardu Green, very heavy removal, a lot of really efficient creatures, some ways to gain life. This deck is very good against decks that are just trying to attack you on a normal front. I'm not sure how it's going to work out against old Worldbreaker and Ulamog, though, so it should be a good time.
So I think your deck against a normal ramp strategy is not great, because like you play a Rhino, I play a Vegetation, and then I just start playing enormous stuff.
Yeah.
But this deck's a little bit slower, just trying to control the game with things like Roast, and use Acceleration in the form of Herald of Kozilek and Hedron Archive, which doesn't match up well against Kolaghan's Command, but hopefully that never comes up, you know?
It's not going to come up.
This deck has like some counter spells and a little bit of different tools than the ramp deck has, so it's not actually ramping, and it's just kind of trying to play its stuff naturally. Conduit Ruin also helps with that. So
yeah.
I thought this might be an interesting take on the archetype. Maybe it's not great, but we'll see.
Yeah, it is just an alternate way to make things cost cheaper, and you know, and you don't have the green acceleration, but you still have a lot of little ways to accelerate, which I really like.
Right, so. And Oblivion Sower, which has basically been cut from the green ramp decks at this point, but is certainly a good card as Modern is showing us. So.
All right, well, let's get to the games and see who takes it down. All right, we're here for the sevens game to see who goes first. First person roll seven loses. Tie reroll. If you roll an 11, you automatically win. If I roll an 11, you roll seven, I get to go first both pre-board games.
Seems like cheating. Eight.
It is a little... It's a little unfair, but...
Four.
You gotta do what you gotta do. Five.
Four.
Oh, no. Oh, this takes way too long. Oh, you
11.
Got 11! And I rolled seven! No!
I win!
So Jared gets to go first both pre-board games.
Yeah!
That's never happened before.
Yeah, that's what Brad was saying.
All right, well, that's a blowout. Let's take a look at these openers.
Okay, yeah. So I could just fetch. I'm definitely keeping my hand. Just thinking about how I'm going to sequence.
All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and take a mulligan. You can talk all about your hand. So basically, I don't have green mana over here, and all my lands come into play tapped. And so even though I have a hand that has both lands and spells and a reasonable amount of both, this hand just doesn't really do enough early on. So we're going to ship it back. So talk about your hand, Jerry.
While you shuffle? All right.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I do need green mana. So I should probably just fetch on turn one. That's about it. My hand is kind of slow and kind of weird, but that's kind of this deck in a nutshell, so.
All right, my six is a lot better. We're going to keep this. I'm going to scry real quick.
I'm going to get a Cinderglade while you do some nonsense.
All right. Well, fourth land is not so bad with this deck, so I think we'll keep it.
It was the top card. I'm glad I fetched.
All right, my turn. Start playing all these lands tapped. Go. All
right, so I'm at 19. That's not bad. Tappy, tappy land. Go.
Playing the four-color brewski over there?
Something like that.
All right, go.
It's like a bunch of half colors. Go.
I guess we're going
half colorless, half blue.
Yeah, I'm going to fetch a basic land here. Since we have a battle land and another basic in our hand, we're just going to go basic, basic into battle land. 19 all.
Yep. I'm just going to continue not doing anything. Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, sounds great. All right, so we're going to need this Wood of Hills to get a black source so we can activate our Shambling Mints, but we'll worry about that next turn.
You done?
Yep.
Mm.
Think I got stuff to do?
Maybe. It's hard to say.
I already told you, my deck is super removal heavy.
Alright. Well, I kind of want to go with this thing to protect this thing. I kind of like the idea of just, like, taking his removal spell and then he can't kill it, but he does have Crackling Doom mana open, so it's kind of awkward. But we'll play the Thought Knots here.
That's pretty good, actually. So,
yeah,
I should have probably played the Fetch Land so I could Murderous Cut here, but it wouldn't have allowed me to get a black source untapped, which I kind of need.
Yeah, I agree with that. I'm just going to take the command.
Oof.
And then all your removal is going to kill my thing, but this is the Vendilion Click mode on the card, pretty much.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we'll just start with a roast since we didn't draw a sweet thing. Ooh.
That's not good.
That was a good peels.
I was trying to protect that one.
Is that the only one? Okay, it's not the only one, but we're definitely going to take that.
Man.
Go.
Stupid Vendilion Click. All right, X is two.
Okay.
Done.
I think we actually just want to go ahead and impulse that guy. We don't really have a lot of ways to exile stuff, and by a lot of ways I mean any. Have like
no Utter End?
Yeah, I think I cut the Utter Ends from the original list just because I want to try to fit some new cards in here. So, Hangerback Walker, I think it's going to get a little bit better now that,
No, you're good.
Now that, Goblin Dark Dweller is going to become a pretty widespread addition to the format, most decks are just going to want to shrink their deck down so that most of their removal spells can be cast off of him.
Yeah, Silk Wrap and Dark Dwellers don't go well together, so.
Yeah. All right, well, I think I'll just attack with a Shambling Vent.
All right, so I'm at 17, you're back to 20.
Yep, go.
And I kind of want to draw a land here. So you have a Murderous Cut that I know about?
Yep. Fortunately, we could not leave up Cut Mana and activate Shambling Vent, but I don't think it's imperative that we cast Cut this turn or anything.
Yeah. So if I drew a land, I could freely Conduit for stuff. But now, if I Conduit and I put something big on top, I know I'm not drawing a land, and then my Shrine's not online. I'm not even sure if I even want to play this Conduit if it's just going to die to a cut. Seems kind of silly. I feel like he's going to have some removal spells, and I might actually want Conduit to get a threat, which is kind of funny, I guess. I could just play Conduit and get, like, a Worldbreaker and then just, like, sit on it.
Yeah.
Hope to draw a land. But I already have a Worldbreaker, too, so it's kind of like, eh.
Yeah.
And I guess if you're killing this, I can just, like, start bringing it back. So, yeah, I should probably just play Conduit and sit. So, we'll attack you for two.
Okay. Yeah, Conduit makes it so you can... Oh, right. But I'm going to kill it, so... Okay, so I'm at 18. Are you going to get a thing?
I don't think so.
Okay.
It's weird, but...
Cool. Cool.
I just want to draw land.
All right. But... Green, black, white. Draw three cards.
That's really good.
15. 1, 2, 3. All right, so we drew a land...
I did feel like this deck wanted some sort of divination type effects. Hedron Archive is like kind of that.
All right. I'm going to go get
14
a Plains. I'm going to cast a Soulfire Grandmaster and a Murderous Cut on Conduit.
Okay. You can do it.
Now, you could make the argument that we should like wait a turn maybe so we can get some extra value out of the Soulfire, but
we probably have plenty of stuff going on.
That's what I'm saying. We got plenty of stuff going on.
You know I have a roast, too.
Yeah.
Well, we definitely didn't want to search for something and put it on top, but maybe we should have shuffled. I'm going to roast that and attack for 2.
Yeah.
You're 12. Good.
Should have shuffled. All right. You got 2 cards?
Yeah. They're really big. Just some big animals.
Alright.
Wobbsy wobbsy.
We'll go to 11. Draw a card.
You're just killing yourself, Todd.
Here you go.
Kill land.
Even if you draw land, that guy can't kill Obnixilus, right?
I know. Wobbsy.
Yeehaw. No.
Vent.
Channel event down.
Go.
You got one card in hand?
I do. So now he can ob my World Breaker. I can start returning it, which is the first time I've ever seen that happen, by the way, if it actually does come down to it. But then maybe I can finish off his ob with my Thopters.
All right.
Oh, this is Exile, too.
Oh, sorry. I forget Exile.
So kill World Breaker?
Yeah. And we're going to...
Breaker 1-9.
Shatter, discard.
No!
And impulse.
No! It was so big!
Here we go. Whatever, man. You're just going to world breaker me every... Oof. Oof.
What should I get? Eight mana?
I guess.
Should I just get another world breaker?
I don't know. Maybe.
Oh, I could get Oblivion Stone? What do you have exiled over here, buddy?
Bunch of fetches.
Why'd you exile all those fetches?
Because I forgot.
I can't even use them, really. I don't know. Sower's okay. I guess then I could just start sacking those for the...
Yeah, for Worldbreaker.
Oh, man. Just all the synergies.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Just all coming together. Yeah, I'll get the Sower good.
All right, we'll draw a card. Go to 10.
Could you even command an impulse last turn?
Nope. No, I cheated.
Scum!
Alright, I don't know what to do. What should we do?
What? Did you have a better play?
Kind of. I could have, like, ticked up Obnixilus and cast Crackling Doom instead.
Well, I had 2 Thopters.
Yeah, I mean, basically, your Thopters would still be in play, but my Obnixilus would still be in play.
And then I would still have old Winnie the Pooh.
Who's Winnie the Pooh?
Void Winnower.
Yeah.
Have it in my hand. But no, whatever. Like, we missed it. That's our bad.
Yeah, that's my B, guys.
And I drew a Conduit of Ruin. If I drew a blank, I probably would make you rewind, but we still have a game, so.
All right, we'll play this, and I'll just go ahead and crackle and doom. I feel like scums.
I'm a 15.
Actually, I can't do another play. I'm just going to do this. All right, go.
All right. So I need colorless mana to activate my thing. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh no, it's Chandra on top.
Oh man.
Jeez.
All right.
Just give you all these sweet lands for free. God, I'm getting browned.
I'm not even sure if that's true. Go.
You have Warbreaker and 15 lands to sacrifice. All right, draw a card. Go to 9. All right, go to 8. I'm going to play a Rhino and a Crackling Doom, assuming I can cast all of it. So Jesus. Let me just make sure.
Green, white, black. Yeah, you look good. Looks good.
Now, yeah, see? All right, so you're 13, and then you go to 10, I go to 11.
Yep.
So you go.
See, how are you getting brown? You have a Rhino and an Omnixilus on 3. I'm going to crack this.
Oh, yeah, I forget that's how that works.
And then I'm going to sack the Heath to return the Worldbreaker. What, man?
Nothing.
I need an Ulamog badly. So return Worldbreaker. This is the only land I have left that's Todd's. Nope, that one too. and I can't activate the Shambling Vent. That's a shame.
It's a Shambling Vent?
It's a Shambling Vent. I mean,
you can technically just not to attack with it.
Sure. It's not a great play, though, I think. All right. Blow up your Nomad Outpost, I guess. What?
Only got one green source.
Oh, that is true.
You could just hit Outpost, though.
No. Kill your Vista. Fine. Exile. And that's it. I guess I'm done.
You're at 9?
Yeah. You're at 11?
I'm at 11.
Oh, man. Winnie the Pooh.
So, don't really want to just kill Worldbreaker because he just gets it back. Card's real good.
Is it good when I have 10 mana?
I don't know. I'm going to draw a card.
Okay.
I'm at 10.
Draw anything, even a removal spell.
I did draw a removal spell. Now you might just die.
Yeah.
All right, cut your guy. I'm not going to exile anything.
That's good for me.
Battle you for 4.
5.
Go.
Return him.
Yep. It's weird because he sacrifices lands but also exiles things.
Yeah. Okay, how greedy do we want to be? Oh, I'm glad I hit this, actually. Because it comes in untapped off Oblivion Sower.
Did you draw another Sower?
I did.
Oh, God.
6. All right, I'll be a little greedy. I'll Sower you. I think I kind of have to. Might just deck you. Yeah, give me that Bloodstained Mire. What's up?
Could just deck me.
Guess I have to crack this and go to 4. And then if you have anything, I die. Break. Oh, I have the Vista for the Shambling Vent now, too. That is cool.
That is true.
Why can't I exile Obnixilus or Siege Rhino?
Because it's not Mold Shambler.
Alright, I'll kill your outpost. I'm all out of Oblivion Servers anyway. Good.
Alright, removal spell. Ooh, that's not good. Alright, well, what we can do is tick down on Oblivion Sower, and then if he attacks Obnixilus, that leaves him dead to my Siege Rhino attack, plus this thing in my hand. So we'll do that. Play another land, say go.
So I'm at 4, you're at 10?
That's what I got.
Maybe I should just attack you. How's that sound?
Ballsy.
I wish there was a sacrifice outlet so I could, like, free vig this thing and, like, kill other stuff. Not that that would really be necessary, but... Oh, dear. No secrets. So you have an impulse? Is that the thing that you're talking about?
I mean, if we're giving away free information, I mean, no secrets, right?
Yeah. I think I do have to attack, though, because I can't just let you just sit and keep doing this. And you haven't played a relevant card. Oh, I got the Cletus and the Chandra?
Yeah. You got all my goods. I could look through my deck, I suppose.
Yeah, and you've played 2 impulses. I just have to attack you, I think.
Okay, 5.
Go.
Draw.
I think...
Attack.
Yeah, vent.
Kill it. kill it again.
You draw the impulse.
Dress you.
Thought-mots. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I can just, like, sit there and let you...
No, I agree.
Ob.
Yeah, I mean, if you just let me draw a few more cards or whatever, like, I'm just going to find something that kills Worldbreaker and kills you that turn anyway.
Right. And if you have the impulse, you just need to find a thing to kill Worldbreaker because you already have the impulse to kill the vent.
Yeah.
Come on, deck! That was not it. These were my first. I was like, oh, we're doing it.
All right, well, he's mulliganing. We'll talk about my hand for a sec. It's definitely a keeper. I suppose we're just going to fetch a green-red with Bloodstain Mire and just hope to activate Shambling Events later on, since we want to make sure we have all of our potential colors in case we draw a Siege Rhino or something, or a Dent Protector. And we're not going to be wanting to attack with Shambling Event anytime early on anyway, so definitely going to keep them.
Got there on the end. Scry.
All right.
I think we need land. Go.
Go.
Not going to fetch because there's no 2-drop I can play. We do want to land. I'm actually fine with mountain, too.
All right, we'll duress you. That's not very good.
All sweet bros.
Wow, that's a lot of biggies. Go.
Go. Why didn't I shuffle my deck?
You just got the Bloodstain Mire just sitting there.
You good, you good.
All right, 19. Well, we don't really want... I guess we could just cast this Painful Truce just to... Like, we're going to have to discard, but...
You want to find a threat, I think.
Yeah, I think so, too. All right, draw three. Ooh, found a couple.
That ain't good.
16, I'm going to move to discard. I think I actually want the land. I think I'm just going to pitch Fire Impulse. That one seems like the worst of
I'm done.
A bunch. All right, cast a Siege Rhinoceros.
I accept.
19 to 17. Why don't you shuffle your deck, man?
Because I thin my deck of a land and I shuffle in a roast.
I know.
I guess the drawing the roast would not be that bad. I'll just draw land. Aha.
Boom.
Take a million damages. I think I have to take three this turn. Because I have to get two mountains.
All right. So you're at 14.
I'm done.
I agree.
You're done for?
You are done for.
Just don't kill my thing. Let me see what happens.
I feel like that's a trap. I feel like he's setting a trap for me.
We'll just call it a draw. And
all right. I'm going to play a Soulfire and a Roast. Is that good?
Targeting.
That guy.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to gain 5 and hit you for 4.
So, yeah, 24.
24 to 10. Your go.
Come on, top deck. No. 9. Go.
Not going to lie, Gerry, this is not looking great for you.
If I could cast Ulamog, I would trigger Kozilek's return.
I think you might still lose.
No, get out of here.
All right. Chandra.
Okay.
I'm going to tick up.
Okay.
And battle you.
Do we have any 3-1 elementals?
I don't know. Don't care.
So I have to block one of your 3-1s?
Or my
and then, no, and then I die, so I have to chump here, and then I'm just DOB.
You go to 1. He's get exiled.
Miss your trigger, man. Big cheats.
Yeah. The second time I cheated. All right, I'll start since I got a lot of junk. Fire Impulse is kind of bad. It does kill Hangerback Walker, which I like, and we don't have a ton of ways to do that anymore, and we don't have a lot of ways to exile him, so it might be a mistake cutting Impulse, because it does also kill the Shambling Vents that you take of mine.
Yep. That's a big deal.
Yeah. No, but the Soulfire Grandmasters, you know, they pair really well with Impulse against the smaller creature-based decks, so... I think we can easily cut these two. It's going to make our Painful Truce a little bit worse. But instead of these, we're going to bring in a package of Dark Petition, Infinite Obliteration, and Obnixilis, number 2. And the obliteration is probably not going to be great, but in combination with duress, we may just be able to snipe some stuff out of his hand.
Yeah, that's the scary thing, is like the Cabal Therapy mode on the card, not necessarily stripping me of like my one Ulamog or whatever.
Yeah, you know? And I think Worldbreaker might actually be problematic enough for this deck that getting rid of is actually important. We're going to bring in the Rose to help kill his 2-4 guys early on. I don't know if it kills very much else, but I think it's just better than Impulse in general.
Conduit, and it can be an Impulse against Hangerback if you just want to get it out of the way.
Yep, bring in Anafenza, which is pretty good against Hangerback, provides us with a reasonable clock, and prevents some shenanigans with Worldbreaker, so you can't bring it back. Hits pretty hard, can't really kill it too often.
Yeah, it's kind of messed up. I definitely don't like seeing those 3-mana 4-4s coming in, because if Todd can't establish a clock, then I think, assuming I draw lands, you know, my late game should kind of beat his, but if he's actually beating me down, then it's really scary, and it makes me, puts a lot of pressure on my roasts, basically.
Yeah, it's possible so. I should just leave these in for beatdown mode. I'm not 100%.
I don't know.
I don't either. Dim Protector seems medium to bad. I might side them out after this game, and then we're going to bring in one more Duress, just because cards like Ugin are really scary. It's not going to have too many targets, but if I hit something, it's usually pretty good, and I do want to have a couple early pieces of interaction since we are cutting impulses. And we already have 2 Duress main, and we're not going to bring in the 4th, though, because we don't really want to draw 2.
Sure. So, on my end, Kozilek's Return is okay. I really want it for the, like, when I cast a 7 drop, I can actually kill a Rhino or Anafenza or whatever. That's the best part of it, and I don't know necessarily that you're siding out, like, all your Soul Fires, because I'm actually kind of scared of the Grizzly Bears, too. So, Void Winnower, not very good at all, I think. What I like instead is the Ruin Processor. I feel like with Siege Rhino and stuff like Crackling Doom, you have a lot of incidental damage, and just being able to gain 5 life might be necessary at some point.
Yep.
And then Ugin's for additional threats. I also have things like Titan's Presence and additional counter spells I could potentially board in, but I'm not sure how good those cards are yet, so I'm going to play a little bit more with just the 2 negates that I have in my main deck, and that's it. I don't even know what I'm doing with my life. This is something else. I'm going to keep.
All right, I'm going to keep. Anfin's is a little wonky on the mana base, but I think we're good here. We're good.
This is the Tri-Land that strikes fear in all my opponents. The Frontier Bivouac.
Yeah, the Kibler Tri-Land. Go.
This is awkward. Go.
All right.
So very awkward.
So we need to get green-red because our next land won't come into play untapped, and we already have a black. Want to Banana Fenza it up.
You have a Banana Fenza?
Sure do. Draw. All right, green, black, white. Rawr.
All right, story checks out.
I do have to double-check my mana every single turn with this deck.
Well, we have a couple of options. We can try and get on the board and then kill some stuff, or we can just kill some stuff. And I'm actually pretty scared, so I'm just going to kill some stuff.
Bang.
It does not use my mana very well, but go ahead. Keep open the coast. Keep open that warping whale.
All right, green, black, white, colorless. Siegeman.
Generic, not colorless.
Oh, yeah, generic. We got to differentiate now.
1722.
You're up.
Well, we'll still just be a coward. I'll roast that thing, too. Go. Slow and steady, baby. Slow and steady.
All right. We'll fetch a black red and cast a Bob.
God, come on, man.
A Bob Nixilis.
Come on, man. I can't beat that.
Sure you can.
Nah, I really can't.
No one can beat Bob Nixilis. All right, I'm going to be at 20 after I draw a card.
Okay.
Aw.
Should have played that on turn 4.
Aw.
What?
You're going to take my Kalidus. I drew Kalidus off of Obnixilis, and I was going to go Kalidus tick down, make it 2-2.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
And now I can't.
Well, I can't beat any of those cards, really. So I'm not sure what to do. Guess it's Kalidus, because that'll just kill me. Yeah, so if you played Anafenza, I played this. I don't know what you do on your turn, but if you go Rhino and then I'm just like roast your 2 things and like start hitting you, then you have to like play this and tick down, but I don't know.
Yeah.
It's also possible I use this to like snipe an Obnixilis, but you had 2 of them.
Did.
I'm a coward. Yeah, I'll take Cletus.
Womp, womp, womp. I feel like so far in testing new cards, just every time we have a potential to discard them, we just always
do. which is good, right? Yeah. I mean, it bodes well for them, certainly.
All right, kill your guy, draw a card. This is weird. All right, well, we don't have a spell mastery yet.
All right.
So I guess we'll just doctor.
Where'd that come from?
I drew it off of your guy. So put me at 23, and you're at 14.
Yes, sir.
I'll play a land, say go. I probably actually should have just roasted your guy and ticked this up.
That's what I thought you were going to do.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Don't have a lot of good ways to deal with planeswalkers.
I got this other Bob Nixilis hanging out, though.
I know. Trust me, man, I get it. I'm at 14, good God.
I'm going to go ahead and do this thing while I'm waiting.
My options are thus. Neither are good. Omnixilis is just kind of beating me up. All right, I'm going to take out your Shambling Vent.
All right. So I got 22 to 14.
Yeah.
My go?
Yep.
All right. Oh, we don't even have a second plaque.
Yeah, that was kind of what I was noticing. It's like, if you want to Obnixilis this, then you can't necessarily play the second one.
Yeah, I mean, Heath couldn't get it, so it's
right.
A little unfortunate. I guess we'll draw three.
Okay.
19. Didn't draw a land. That's kind of gross.
Love it. Bob him.
No, I'm going to draw a card.
Oh.
Eh, maybe I should kill him.
I mean, I'm at 14. I'm like, if you just want to sit there drawing cards, that's cool. I'll play that game.
No, you're right.
No, just draw a card, please. All
right. 10 to 19.
Yeah.
Your go.
I was going to roast your Rhino and kill your Ob.
Dead.
Go. I have one artifact in play and one card in my hand.
Yeah, we did draw.
Come on.
I guess I could get a little greedy and try to painful truce into
Do that, Todd.
Go. I'm good, dog. I'm good.
Could have not roasted, but I'm at 10, so that seems like a pretty bad idea. Oh, I guess I should sack a land and return Worldbreaker. Right?
Sure.
2 and 3.
Checks out.
What's exiled?
I said checks out.
Yeah. And then, hi-ya! Smush your black source.
See, now I'm going to lose.
Go.
You tricked me.
I don't know if I tricked you.
You did trick me. Tricked me pretty good. I can't cast a single spell except for roast.
Get him. Roast him. Hi-ya! 5.
14.
Go.
Wow, Windswept Teeth is horrible.
Yeah.
Worst card in the deck by a mile. Should just be...
Dude, I think Land Destruction is actually good.
Polluted Delta. It is.
I'm just going to start, like, maining Crumble to Dust.
Yeah.
5.
I'm at 9.
You're at 6. I guess I don't have to tap all that.
Well,
do that. Go. All right.
Couldn't beat the World Breaker. So, okay. Ooh, Black Source. See, I got a 9, and then basically just dead. I guess... Would you just minus 4 the Ugin? I don't think so.
I might have to, because like, if I could just attack you for 5 and then you have to chump, that would be one thing, but you don't have to, so it's kind of tough.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to Rhinodopolis you.
Alright, 7 to 9.
Here you go.
Maybe I'll just draw another Ugin.
Kinda does it.
Kinda does it.
That's frightening. I'm gonna block.
What?
I'm gonna block. That is, there's no way you'd attack if you didn't just have some that killed me.
Should I do this first then? Takes away the option. I just didn't think you were gonna block. All right, upstairs. You're at six. I'll save this return for later. Go. Yeah.
All right, go to five.
I guess I should have cast return and shot your rhino.
Maybe.
Dealt you five instead of three. I don't know, I deal you two more damage, but I discard a return. I'm not sure if that's better or worse. There's no shuffle trigger on this, right? It just dies and then it's dead forever? That's so sad.
I really should have, like, one way to kill Nugan in my deck if I'm going to have Dark Petition.
That would make too much sense.
All right. I'm going to say go, and then on your upkeep, I'm going to...
Crackling Doom Redirect.
Crackling Doom Redirect.
That stinks.
Yeah, I'm at five. I don't think there's a whole lot of outs here.
Shoot you. Rebuy!
All right, so I go to two.
I don't need all these mountains. Get out of here.
All right.
And I exile a swamp.
Sure. Flow mana off the swamp, and I'll cut that guy.
You too.
I guess I shouldn't do that. Alright, this is gone. Yeah, so I'm at two, you're at seven.
Yep. And I have an Ugin. Hope you gain some life, so I have to ultimate it.
Alright, well, Painful Truths for three.
That resolves. Done.
You're good.
Alright, you're negative one.
Ultimate.
It's like not even that good.
It's really not.
Do you get to draw some more cards though? Oh, another Ugin. Oblivion, some other stuff.
All right, I get to be on the play.
Lucky.
This hand's pretty good. We got all our colors. The infinite obliteration's looking a little wonky because we basically just want to go fetch basic, fetch basic, fetch dual land, and our color combinations are a little weird to cast infinite obliteration. So I think I'm just gonna pocket that one for later. Just hope I draw another black.
Sure. Cards. I'm keeping. This is a different hand than what we've seen so far. You done?
Yeah. Plains, Gui.
Sunk. Go. Save that one for later.
Alright. Draw.
You would 19. You would 18. Grizzle Bizzle.
Yeah, I boarded it back in the Grizzly Bears.
Uh-oh.
To try to get some beats on since I'm on the play. Uh-oh. Oof. It's actually real good.
Is it?
Well, in general.
Go.
I don't know about situationally. Whoop. That's not great. Pow. I'm going to gain 7 up to 25. I assume you're going to not block and go to 17. That would be my guess.
Good guess.
Here you go.
Go. No point in really trying to attack.
I actually just fetched all wrong. I'm stupid. I was trying to fetch so that I could still cast Inoffensa, and I just messed it all up.
Yep.
All right.
Yep, show did.
Battle.
Double block.
Crackle and Doom, yeah.
I'll sack the Thopter.
Okay. So I'm going to gain 4.
You at 29, I'm at 15. Well, 28 now, I guess. Sound about right?
Something like that. Whenever I can find my two Smoldering Marshes that are right on top. And then play this, so you go. So, I'm going to be at 27.
What is happening?
Everything is said and done.
Go.
Yeah, magic the shuffling, am I right?
I recommend playing a third land in your games of magic.
Well, yeah. That's why I'm a champion.
Yeah. So we're going to try out this old double block thing again. I wasn't lying. Double block.
So I'm at 29. Then I'm going to go to 32. You're going to go to 14. I'm going to run a Doppelus you.
32 to what? No, I got dinged by Doom. I'm at 12.
I had you go to 19, 17. Oh, wait, no, that was when you didn't block. Yeah, you're right. You're at 12.
Whee!
Rhinodopolis, huh? Dr. Siegeman, Rhinodopolis. You have two left?
Two cards. You got a lot more than me, though.
I have seven. You want to cast Eureka?
Kinda. Put this into play.
Just get this Grim Llamomancer ready.
Yeah, we found the tokens. Don't worry.
Oh, crap. So I could do this. I'm not passing yet. I'm definitely casting a spell. I could do this. I think in order to win, I have to do this, though, and just take a little beat down ski. All right, get you down to 31.
Yep.
Harold. Welcome, Harold. Oh, God. Oh, God.
I kind of want to just neg four. But, we're just going to go to the dome skis.
Block one.
All right.
If I had a fourth land, this is my turn.
That's pretty good.
Just get them both. So I take seven down to five?
Yep.
Okay. Well, can't possibly win. Cannot possibly win.
I have a feeling the best mode on Chandra is just going to be the plus one. It's so good. It's and just, you get to use Grim Llamomancers.
Yeah, it's just a sick haste threat, you know?
Yeah. Freaking six mana ball lightning. Well, that's not. That when you say it like that, it doesn't sound great.
Ball lightning every turn.
Yeah. Boom.
What am I supposed to do here?
Nailed it. I don't know.
Lose?
Attack both at Chandra. Hold up negate.
That doesn't sound good. That sounds pretty bad, actually. Mm. All right, this is my hand. I can play the TK. That's basically my best play, because anything else, I only do one spell, and this seems like more effective. So I could, like, double block Rhino, block here, and then you get to draw a card. But you could also just minus four and kill all my stuff. And
yeah, put you to one.
Yeah,
and then...
and draw a card. Good God.
Chandra tight.
Oh, my God. Especially with big creatures.
Herp, herp.
Well, I want all those turns back where I didn't play lands.
But you played all these Hangerback Walkers.
Yeah, I sure did.
You would have took so much damage from my Soulfire Grandmaster.
So how do we live? Even if we had another land, now it'd be okay if we could play another Herald and Roast.
Attack for two, cast Roast.
I think we have to hit that thing.
Womp.
Yeah.
Womp.
Gah. It's a sad turn.
Yeah. Battle. Yep, you go to two.
These don't actually trample, right? But the Llamomancers say trample?
That is correct. You don't. They do not trample.
Okay.
Unfortunately. Well, that's kind of tilting. We have to use these too, I bet. All right, exile. Here you go.
No!
You gonna play some Toit Herald Blockers?
Oh my God. Ugh. This is so bad. Go. I'm at two, Todd.
Alright, I'll cut one, and then...
I'm dead.
And then I'm gonna tick up, and you gonna get...
Get llamaed.
Llamaed.
What sound do llamas make?
Wah. Wah.
That's like a sheep. So I'm on the play for game five, because I've lost the vast majority of the games. And, whatever. I'm in there.
I really need to draw, like, four lands in a row. That'd be perfect.
Good.
We're gonna keep it and hope we just get super lucky.
Oh, thank you. Go.
Yeah, I could just like fetch so that I can Soulfire on two, which may not be that bad. We don't have a basic force in our deck though, so it's not actually going to help us cast Anafenza, which is not something I really considered when I put Anafenza on my sideboard.
Banana Fenza. I wish I had Reality Smasher.
Go.
Just get sideboard into a leaner deck. Go. Black, red, green, white.
Yep.
And then play Mountain.
I really hope I draw Mountain.
Me too. Here you go, buddy. Put that one on top.
Really?
No.
Okay. We're probably just going to play a turn 3 Grizzly Bear and not a land.
Oh, that would be great. I might have a shot. The time walk is on the other foot, Todd. I don't know what that means. Is that a land? Yes! I drew a mountain.
God, I want to draw a mountain.
TK.
Have at it. Thanks, buddy. Now I get to draw a land. Maybe.
Can't even cast the cut.
Not yet. I'm going to draw a fetch land. Don't you worry.
Oh, man. Your cards are all so good, minus those grizzly bears.
Man, if those grizzly bears were just like duress and roast.
Jeez. Might be in trouble. Yeah, I really don't want you to cast anything this turn. But then I don't get to accelerate properly. Yeah, I'll take your roast. Go.
Whoop.
Whoop, 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 whoop.
Guess what I drew?
Hell yeah. Go.
Drawn more grizzly bears than lands.
So I did a little different sideboarding. Okay, and I did leave in the two returns. That's good.
No.
I wouldn't have to check my sideboard if I had it in my hand.
Okay.
That's not how that works.
I thought you were just like, drew both returns. You're like, I thought I sideboarded two of these out.
Oh, no.
Like, I'm good and brown.
No, I would definitely wait for you to play the third Soulfire.
Yeah.
Not that I knew that you drew that one or whatever, but no. Look at this one.
That's a tight one.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. So I don't want to send. And I do want to protect my thing yet again. So I think I'll TK your Kolaghan's Command. And then I'm done.
Whoop.
Resolves. I messed up. The Kozilek's returns in my sideboard are on the bottom. I couldn't just, like, draw from the top and just be in the gate.
The gate's not bad right now.
It's not bad. It is not bad.
Make you feel safe over there.
Well, should I be a coward?
I should
probably be a coward. Play the Archive.
Okay.
And I still don't really want you drawing cards, so go ahead.
Is this how you feel?
Yes.
Okay.
Except I have like 10 mana cards in my deck.
Yeah.
I will gain 2 life.
All right.
22.
I'm 18.
Maybe we should cash in this archive. I got some lands.
I want you to cash in those Thought Knots here is what I want you to
do. Oh, I know what I want to draw. Yeah, I definitely want to cash this in. Didn't get there. Beats. Beats by Todd Anderson.
Oh, they're coming. I'm assembling my Soul Force.
Yeah.
Here they come.
What was it called in Versus?
Back row? Yeah, this is my defensive row.
No, it was like reinforcing or something silly.
Well, that's only if you block with them.
Well, right. All right. Herald. Still not attacking. Go.
Oh. Perfect. Right on time and everything. Ooh. GTs.
Come on, man.
Look, buddy. It's not my fault.
You're just like, boom, put those back into play.
I might actually win if I get to do that.
Yeah, I mean, you would Chandra kill all my stuff?
Yeah, that'd be tight.
Draw a bunch of cards.
I don't even know what to do. I can, like, cut a Thought Knots here. It doesn't really accomplish anything except me drawing a card. That's not even really an accomplishment. So he can still, even if I kill his herald, he can still cast Worldbreaker. Basically Murderous Cuts or Anofenza. That's the only really option that I have.
Well, you can cast Anofenza.
I hate this deck. Alright. Well, I'm going to cut a Thought Knots here.
Dead. Done?
I guess. Can sack two guys and hit you for four. Doesn't seem worth it.
Not really.
Alright, note to self. Don't play Anofenza in this deck sideboard.
21.
It's real hard to cast. Because we don't have Basic Forest. We could just put Basic Forest in the deck, and that would fix, like, all the issues with the Anofenzas, but...
Yeah, I had Basic Forest when I played that deck in Denver.
Yeah, yours was different, though. You had, like, Abzan Charm and stuff.
Well, right. I would not play Abzan Charm now.
What 8-drop are you casting? Or 9-drop, I guess.
I don't know yet. Should probably kill one of your lands. Thanks, man.
Ugh.
Vista or Marsh? Like, what can you do with white-black? Like, nothing, really. I'll just kill your Marsh. Exile it.
I got two exile piles.
Okay. I'm done.
Great. So am I.
Done four. Whoa. Lucky. Now you can cast Anofenza.
Kind of.
Oh. Oh, there it is. What? Dromoka's Command off a swamp?
Did they get exiled? No.
No. Smush.
Was that 11?
Yeah.
I'm at 6.
Damage on the stack. I'll gain 3 life.
Okay.
25.
Have you from a fetch down to 21 up 24?
All right.
Man.
All right.
Look at you.
All right. Cheating.
Look at you. All right, 5 up to 8, Rhinodopolis.
Oh, sorry, I meant this one. All right, Oblivion Sword Cheat. I was just going to go off.
I know. All right, so unfortunately, 3 of those games were just us stuck on lands, which kind of stinks.
Yeah, 26 is not enough. Or no. You have 27, right?
No, I only have 26.
Okay.
I started with a mana base from a guy from the last Classic who got, like, third place, so.
Okay.
Probably, I think Tenjin was the one who started playing 27.
Yeah.
And, I mean, 27's probably right. You have so much to do with your mana. There's no, like, such thing as flooding in this deck, right? Like,
not really. It's tough to run out of gas, too.
Yeah, with 4 Soulfire Grandmasters, you know, like, all you need is, like, one spell, even if you have 10 lands and you just start going crazy.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I actually think that Cletus would have been awesome that one game where you maybe discard it.
Definitely.
Chandra looked fantastic.
Yep.
Just, I mean, so far when I've cast her, I've used the plus one every time.
But there are other lines, right? Like, I have to take into consideration the fact that you can minus, you know?
Yeah.
And it, like, has to change how I play. Like, obviously I could walk into it and make it really good, but it just means that I can't do that.
Yeah, and I mean, I think people are just really underestimating the pressure that 6 damage a turn really, really presents, you know?
Yeah, especially when you have Rhino and Crackling Doom already, you just nickel and dime them a little bit, and then 2 Llamamancers without Trample, just getting in there.
Yeah, I think the 0 ability on Chandra is going to be a lot more relevant in something like Sphinx's Tutelage deck. We had that last week, Brad was playing that against me, and... There was a game where he almost decked me with just the 0 the turn he cast it. He had 2 tutelages in play.
That's
he
insane.
He milled me. He had 10 triggers.
That's insane.
Yeah, it was kind of cool.
Okay. That's something I did not consider.
Yeah. But yeah, let's talk about your deck, because mine had mostly old cards with a few new ones, and your deck was the one with mostly new ones.
So my archives were very weak to Kolaghan's Command. I never really like went nuts with Herald of Kozilek or anything. It was mostly just like... I play a Thought Knot Seer and then a Worldbreaker, and, like, that's my deck, which is probably not good enough. Oblivion Sower looked really good, though. I like, if I played this deck again, I'd probably just cut the conduits and play more Sowers.
See, I think Oblivion Sower is just nuts in general. I think we all really underestimated that card.
Well, like, when that card first came out and people were first building the Eldrazi ramp decks, they just all played four in that deck. And then I remember testing for that Pro Tour where it was like, oh, you get, like, a fetch land you can't use or, you know, just, like, you brick or whatever. Like, it just didn't seem that good.
Yeah. I mean, excuse me. I think there are some cards you can play to make it a little better. I mean, obviously, like, pairs pretty well with Worldbreaker on both ends. Like, you get to exile their land first, maybe, and then you get off the Oblivion Sower. But then later on, like, even if you have these dead fetch lands, we saw you bring it back twice off of just these extra fetch lands that didn't do anything. So I think Worldbreaker does add a lot to being able to play Oblivion Sower in the deck, and I think it's just good.
Yeah, the question is whether or not you want to mess with Oblivion Sower and Worldbreaker in that combination, or if you kind of just want to go past those and just focus on playing Ulamog and Kozilek.
Yeah, sure. I thought that maybe your deck should maybe play one Kozilek just because of how... like, your deck's not super ramp-heavy, right? So, like, drawing cards in your deck is actually pretty good, whereas drawing cards in a ramp deck is usually going to mean drawing a bunch of more ramp when you already have, like,
right,
10 in play or whatever.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I thought the Shrines were more important than Sanctums, and I still think that, just because Shrine is just, like, a free ramp, basically. And if I had, like, a Sanctum package, then I would have played it, but I didn't want to play too many 10s with the Conduits. Like, I guess that's a Sanctum package-ish, but I had the Void Winnower instead because I felt like the actual ramp decks were going to be bad matchups.
Yeah, I think that's definitely reasonable. Yeah, I don't know. I don't got much else. I thought that the roasts were interesting. At least, you know, you had something to do early on.
Yeah.
You know, even though, like, there were most games you didn't really do anything on the first few turns, once you started, like, hitting your stride, your deck just looked great.
Yeah, it looked sweet. I do want, like, some sort of card draw, like, maybe even, like, Oath of Jace or whatever. Like, something like that. Something to just, like, filter through the awkward cards, maybe discard some bad ones. Even discarding, like, Kozilek's Return might be sweet. I don't know. Like, I don't want a Divination. I want, a draw three. You know, like a Concentrate or something.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Gotta work on it.
Yeah, I also think Reality Smasher might be good, and the Land Destruction is so good against these four-color decks, too.
Yeah, man, I think I tricked... So I was, like, listening to you. You were just like, do this thing, and I had a feeling that I was just going to get punished, like, real bad for, like, blowing up my Ulma, or blowing up my Obnixilis and stuff, and I did. And I'm not blaming you. I'm blaming myself.
Well, you cheated in game one,
I
so it's okay.
In game one. So we went 2-2 asterisk.
I would have won that game, but sure. We'll call it an asterisk.
All right, guys. Well, be sure to join us this weekend as we go to Columbus for the second Standard Open of the new Standard season featuring Oath of the Gatewatch in Columbus. Who's the commentator?
Matthias Hunt and Ryan Overturf. This is Ryan's first show. I know him from way back. We're both from Minnesota. Really smart dude. Really cool. Good at Magic, and I think he's going to do good stuff.
All right, should be fun. Yeah, I'm gone. You going to that one, or are you going to go to a Mexico City? Or
I'm not sure. There's also GP Vancouver. Like, so I'm on top 16 of the leaderboard, right?
Yeah.
Which is awesome.
Yeah,
two buys. But I'm also, like, you know, trailing far behind Jeff Hoogland, like, by a lot. And
sure.
I know it's, like,
you
top
don't have
three.
To beat him,
I know it's top three, but it's, like, it's Hoogland, BBD's up there, Tenjum.
Caleb Chair from just winning.
Yeah, Caleb also. And it's tough to keep up with those guys. I don't know if I can pass them, but, like, if I do well in Atlanta, then I'm gonna be like, obviously I'm gonna love Standard, right? I'm gonna be like, oh, this format's great. I'm so
Jared
smart.
Thompson.
Yeah,
you take the crown away from Brad.
Oh, nothing would make me happier. But if I get a lot of points this weekend in Atlanta, then it will encourage me to go to Columbus, whereas if I just, like, get 2 points or whatever, I'll just be like, I might go to a Grand Prix instead. Maybe I'll stay home. I don't know, because got to work on Modern for the Pro Tour also. But, yeah.
Well,
so
if you do bad in the Standard Open, you can play the Modern Challenge the next day.
That
or
is
the
true.
Modern Classic,
that is
rather.
That is true.
Get you some points there.
Michael Majors and I were just talking about updating Martyr with Eilie.
Get out.
Dude, Martyr sounds sweet. Lingering Souls? Blow up all your stuff. I'm on this land destruction.
It's non-land.
Oh. Necrotic Sliver of Myria, then. We'll do that. That's way better.
All right, guys. Well, that's going to be all for us today. Thanks for watching the Verse series on SarcyGames.com. For Gerry Thompson, I'm Todd Anderson, and we'll see you soon.